on the title of this paper, in this year, which we are going to see, e-science at nanoscale. This is the old name, but from this year, the new name of this subject has been changed as physics and chemistry at the nanoscale. So in this subject we are going to see almost four chapters. So one belongs to introduction to nanoscience, in which we are going to see all the aspects of the nanoscience, nanomaterials, okay, and what are the different effects which we can see at the nanoscale, and why nanoscale is important, what is the history of nanomaterials, okay. So all these things we are going to see in this chapter. Chapter second belongs to making of nanostructures. So basically, if you want to make some nanomaterial, can we make it? So of course yes. So what are the basic approaches? So there are two basic approaches to make the nanomaterials. One is top-down approach, and second one is the bottom-up approach. So in the top-down approach is an approach where we are going to see how the nanomaterials are growing, okay, from bigger size to small size, okay. So when we are making some material in such a way that the material is changing its size from bigger to smaller, then we say that this approach is top-down approach, okay. So there are some techniques in which we are going to see that the nanomaterial is possible to grow from a bigger material to a smaller nanoscale material, okay. And these techniques we will learn in this chapter. In the next chapter, as you can see, chapter 3, making of nanostructures, and now the approach is bottom up, okay. So here you have to understand that here again we are going to make the nanomaterials, but now the growth process, okay. So for example, if you look at our nature, we can see that the tree grows, okay, but the trees grow from a seed, okay. So seed is small, and then it started to grow, okay, and then it become bigger and bigger, okay. So here the growth is from smaller thing to bigger thing, okay. So if we are going to make the nanomaterial from smallest thing like atoms, so atoms come together and they started to form the nanomaterial, then this type of approach is called as a bottom up approach, okay. So there are so many techniques which we are able to do in our laboratories, where we can produce these nanomaterials by using a bottom up approach. And the last chapter belongs to visualization and manipulation tools. So once you prepare the nanomaterial, you should be able to check whether the material you have prepared is basically is in the range of a nano or not, okay. What is the size of this material, what is the shape of this material, okay, whether it is in the rod shape, whether it is in the spherical shape, okay. What is the details about its microstructure. So if you want to observe that, then you have to you need a special techniques, visualization techniques, okay, which are more powerful in magnification. So basically we will see some techniques like scanning electron microscope, tunneling electron microscope, okay, and scanning probe microscopes, okay. So there are several techniques by which you are able to visualize it. And in addition to that, you can we manipulate these nanoparticles at that scale? The meaning is that can you able to manipulate the position of these nanomaterials, okay, on some chip or wherever you want? You want to grow the nanomaterials at some places, you don't want to grow it, okay? So in that case, you need some manipulation techniques. And one manipulation technique which has got a Nobel Prize for its invention is optical tweezers. Okay, so it's some kind of tweezer, okay, which basically controls the nanomaterial using some sort of laser materials. Okay, so this is the introduction of our subject. So we'll see soon. Each chapter in detail and try to understand this subject in more detail. Okay, thank you.